something with it, or if you can wait until you go out the door?
Sure.
And I'll get a shot of you leaving.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Sweden, Gothenburg, and Volvo Car Corporation. This area around here is truly the cradle of Volvo, and it all started here, just here, 78 years ago, with the first classic Volvo called Jakob. And the area you're sitting in here, this building here, is built 20 years ago, and the purpose from the very beginning was to create a factory delivery center reflecting the values and the intentions of Volvo for customers coming from overseas. So as Johan said, my name is Torg Mekka. I'm responsible for the international sales, and besides people like yourself, Americans, Canadians coming over to pick up a car, we also sell cars to diplomats, embassies, all over the world, and of course also military personnel, very much American soldiers based outside the United States, could be British soldiers, could be UN soldiers, who has a special status, and that means that we direct special offers to this type of customers. Have any of you been in Sweden before? Is this your first? Some have been in Sweden. All right, that's good. So I hope you had a good experience, a good impression of Sweden. And I understand as well that you came in Sunday and you've seen something of Gothenburg. And as you know, Gothenburg is the second largest city in Sweden. And you're going to Stockholm. And being these two big cities, you will see the west side and the east side of Sweden. I'm not Swedish, but I've noticed that people from Stockholm always have discussions with people from Gothenburg about which city is the best.
That's very true, Tom.
Yeah. I think Johan is from Gothenburg, but your colleague is from Stockholm, isn't that right?
That's right. So my current boss is from Stockholm, and we always have a discussion about which is the best city. But I heard the comment yesterday that somebody said that the Gothenburg is a very friendly city, and that is the slogan for Gothenburg. It's the friendliest city in Sweden.
And I have to say, as a foreigner coming here to Gothenburg, I have to say I think it's a wonderful city, and I hope you enjoy it as well. And I know you're always very nice when you talk about Stockholm. So,
be careful. It's my own time.
Yeah. It's your own time. Well, anyway, this factory delivery center here, we receive about 6,000 people, and we greet the people here at the counter, 6,000 people a year. And that means in the delivery room that you see down at the end of the hall here, we deliver about 2,500 cars this year. And this is all mainly due to the excellent work that Johan and his colleagues are doing in the United States, in Irvine, in California, where the sales office is. And year over year now, for the last five, 6 years, they have been increasing their sales. So I can only say that we are very happy about this development. We are very happy to have you coming here and visiting us. So later today, you will receive the car of your choice, and you will be on your way to Stockholm. And I can only say that here in Sweden, mostly traffic is no problem. And I also think it's fair to say that the Swedish drivers are very defensive driving, and they are very considerable in their driving. So I think you will also there find it to be a nice trip going across Sweden. But anyway, I just want to mention, as you probably know, that Volvo is worldwide renowned for its safety in inventions and its safety focus. It's good to know, probably, while you're out there driving. And also, I would like to tell you that just 500 yards from here, we have the Volvo Safety Center. That is the place where all the inventions and all the designs and all the tests are made. And we're very proud of this, of course. And being a member of the Ford Motor Company group, it also means that we have the responsible for the other brands within the whole group. And that means that all brands comes here and they will have their cars tested. So just before the summer, Aston Martin brought in their brand new DB9, and they totally wrecked it over here. And for people who liked cars, it seems like a pity to see such a nice car wrecked, but it's of course all for a good purpose. So. I hope you'll enjoy your visit to Sweden and that you'll enjoy your trip with Volvo across Sweden. We're very happy to have you here. If there's anything we can do to help you or to make it more comfortable, let us know. So have a good time, have fun, and please drive safely. Thank you very much.
It's, I think, for most people, a trip of a lifetime.
I would certainly advise anyone, yes, do it.
You can't go wrong. If you're buying a Volvo, this is a better way to do it.
The only way to get the price in our range where we could afford the price was to take the overseas delivery. It was the absolute best price. We read in the brochures that Gothenburg was the friendliest city in Sweden, and we're ready to agree.
It was great being picked up at the airport and being driven over, and checking into the hotel was easy. I mean, it was very, very, everything went really smooth, so it's
it is king for a day. And you get to keep the crown.
We felt like we were royalty. Swedish royalty, of course. But on this trip, we decided that we wanted to just explore Sweden, because we had never seen Sweden before. So we decided that we wanted to see Sweden and Norway and the fjords.
With this car, I've been Belgium, Netherlands, Luxembourg, Germany, France, Switzerland, Italy, Denmark, and back here.
it's too good to be true. It can't be possible that we get the car at this wonderful price, that we get the airlines tickets, that we're going to Europe, stay for a month.
The words from a few of our customers. And this actually started right after World War II, when the Americans were rebuilding Europe. And they saw these funky cars on the European roads, and it said Volvo on the back. And they thought that I want to get a Volvo as well. So they contacted the factory in Sweden and said that I want to buy a Volvo, but I want you to help me to ship the car back to the U.S. once my assignment here is over. And Volvo said, "Fine, we're gonna do that for you." So that is actually how Volvos first came to the U.S. That was before there was an importer of Volvo cars in North America. And the military personnel, as Torben mentioned before, is one customer group that we worked with in the U.S. as well, as part of the overseas delivery program. So, and another group is expatriates and diplomats. The military personnel is personnel that have been on an international assignment. Expatriates is like myself, that are temporarily working in the U.S. on a contract. And diplomats are foreign nationals that are working as diplomats in the U.S. But the main focus for the overseas delivery program is the tourist customer group. That is, any American can be a tourist. So tourists are everywhere, and that the tourist group is about 90 to 95% of our total sales. The way the program works, is that the customer goes into a regular Volvo or certified Volvo US retailer to order their Volvo through the overseas delivery program. And they can order exactly the car they want, so we call it that it is a tailor-made car. They specify exactly what they want to have on the car, options, packages, etc. And the dealers submit the order to our office in Irvine, where we punch in the order into the factory system. About 15 days later, the customer get an order confirmation package in the mail that confirms the car they have ordered, and also contact information for our travel agency. Because part of this wonderful package is two round-trip tickets with Scandinavian Airlines and a free hotel night in Gothenburg. So about 2 to 3 months later, the customer board the plane to Sweden. And they arrive here at the airport in Gothenburg, where you arrived yesterday. They're being picked up by a private transfer. So there would be somebody waiting at the airport for them with a sign saying, "Welcome, Mr. and Mrs. Smith." They're taken downtown to the SAS Scandinavia Hotel, the same hotel that you stayed at last night. They spend the night there. Next morning, the driver will pick them up again and take them out here to the factory delivery center. So the first thing they go through is the documents that is part of the car delivery. It's the title, the bill of sale, and so on. And also the insurance, the car insurance they need to drive the car in Europe. So it's a green card in there explaining the details about the insurance. After that, they take delivery of their, or presented with their new Volvo here in the showroom out there. And that is a very exciting moment for many customers. They see how the car are brought in through the garage door, and one customer actually explained it. It's like it was like seeing my children being born. But they are very excited about the moment when the car drives out there and they're presented with it, and the delivery specialists here will go through all the details about the features of the car. After that, they are taken up to the lunch restaurant we have here, where they will get the famous Swedish meatballs. It's Swedish meatballs with lingonberries and gravy and potatoes. So that's a really fun part of the delivery experience as well. After that, it's probably the highlight, one of the highlights of the trip. It's the factory tour. So they are really excited to go on the factory tour and see how quality and care are manufactured into each and every Volvo. So the factory tour is really something they are excited about when they've seen that as well. After that, they're taken back here to the factory delivery center again, and then they drive off in their new Volvo. After that, they continue touring in Europe or in Sweden. They can drop off the car once they are ready to go back to Sweden, go back to the US at one of our 21 drop-off locations throughout Europe. The maximum time a tourist can stay here is 6 months, based on the Swedish tax regulations. So 6 months is the maximum time they can spend here with their Volvo. Then we have promised the Swedish tax authorities that we will make sure the car gets back. So the 6 month rule is very important. They fly back to the US to their home. The car will arrive at the dealership at about 6 to 10 weeks later, depending on where in the US they live. So that is the process. And the key features here is that the key benefits of the program is that you get 2 free round trip tickets on Scandinavian Islands, that's included. The free hotel night is included as well. Home shipment services is included. We take the car back to the US for the customers. And 15 days car insurance here in Europe is included as well. So they get 15 days, but can purchase then up to 6 months extra insurance. And on top of all these great things that you get is a approximate 8% saving on the US MSRP. So the cars are priced at about 8% below the US MSRP. Yeah.
When you bring it back to the U.S., you have to pay taxes on it, I presume, to register it. Is it taxed as a new car or as a used car?
That varies from state to state, actually. But that is something that is, taxes are so individual. So that is the customer's responsibility to find out what taxes apply to them. So, and of course, the retailer help out with that usually in the state as well.
Is the dealer compensated for this program at all?
Yeah, the dealer is compensated for this program. So,
do you mind explaining that a little bit more? Because I mean, obviously, that's part of where the savings comes from. But explain from the dealer perspective, because you know, I've actually done this. We have done this, and you know, at first there was some reluctance from the dealer, but they are compensated. So, which is better for them? To sell a car or to administer one of these?
It's actually about the same.
So to them, it makes no difference.
They make the same money on a dealer inventory sale and a overseas delivery sale. So it's really no difference.
Does it go against their quotas, sales quotas?
Yeah, they get credit for the sale. Yeah, uh-huh. So it's full credit for the overseas sale they do as well.
So,
but I would like to say that with an overseas delivery sale, they create a great ambassador for Volvo. Once the customer have gone through this whole process, they are very excited about the brand and about the whole idea of owning a Volvo.
Granted, but so where's the savings come from?
The savings come from that we don't offer any incentives on financing or leasing. So you know that when manufacturers, car manufacturers, advertise lease rates, like $299, $399, and so on, we don't offer any incentivized lease rates like that. So if you want to lease a car, you go to your bank and say, this is the car I'm going to buy, I want to through the overseas program, and I want to lease it. And then they come up with the monthly payment, which is usually higher through the overseas program than if you buy a car from the dealer inventory.
And does that car come out of their allotment as well?
No, that comes out of a separate allotment. So we have a different allocation of cars through the program.
Are they flying business class or coach?
They fly coach, but they can upgrade to business class for a very favorable price. I'm going to get back to that later on in the presentation.
Yeah, we'll probably answer most of your questions as we go through the presentation.
Yeah.
and then we'll do the Q&A at the end.
Yep. Good. So this is just an example of pricing on an XC90 2.5T all-wheel drive, model year 2006. The US MSRP, our price of the car is about 8% lower than the US MSRP, but that's only on the base price of the car. The options and the packages are priced equally. So the difference is also that we don't charge for destination. That's included in the price of the car as well. So if you look at the bottom line here, the overseas delivery car is about $3,000 cheaper. So why does Volvo do this? Why are we in the overseas delivery business? Yeah, as I said before, we create the Volvo customers for life. These customers become great ambassadors for the brand. They become true Volvo freaks, if you want to call them that. They are really excited about the whole experience and the value that the Volvo ownership brings to them. And you can see here as well that we have a 99% customer satisfaction. So customers that come here and go through the overseas program are very happy about their experience. I can just take as a comparison here, as an example, that it's a dealer in Charlotte, North Carolina. He had a customer come in here last summer, and that customer have brought him 5 other sales in a year. So these are people that really speak about Volvo and the program. They don't necessarily sell another Volvo through the program, but they sell another Volvo because this customer was so happy about the experience and how Volvo take care of its customers.
We have a member in the Volvo Club that has done this 20 times.
Amazing.
They buy a new car through here every other year.
Okay, great. So, and we have a segment-leading offer that is based on the Care by Volvo philosophy. As you could see in my description of how the process works, we take care of the customer from the day they walk into the showroom to the day they travel back to the US again. So it's a complete package where we follow the customer step by step very closely to ensure a flawless process. None of the competition has such a complete package as Volvo offers. We have a more full approach to the program. Of course, it's also a way for the retailers and for Volvo to expand our customer base. 70% of the cars we sell is conquest sales, meaning that 70% of the customers didn't previously own a Volvo. So they are new to the Volvo brand, and 42% say they wouldn't have bought a Volvo if we didn't offer this program. So this is truly a way to expand our customer base and get new customers that didn't think about the Volvo previously excited about the Volvo brand. Slide about our sales for 2004. We managed to close the year as the number one selling manufacturer in the segment. You see here that the Saab, Mercedes, and BMW are the ones that we compete against. Porsche has a program as well, but that it's very limited, and there you actually have to pay extra to go to Europe and pick up your Volvo. So you pay about $4,000 or $5,000 extra to pick up the Porsche here in Europe. So we closed the year at about 100 cars ahead of BMW.
Do you have any comparisons on the other, on the other programs, Mercedes and BMWs?
You mean what they offer?
Well, in terms of the overseas delivery program.
What they offer in the program.
Exactly. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. If I can come back to you on that question,
sure.
I would appreciate it.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks. So here's a little bit about the segment growth. The segment has been growing in the past 5 years, and last year was the first year when the segment hit 6,000 cars. So, and we have a good had a good lead here last year, as you can see here, with 2,327 cars. And we're, of course, happy that that customers appreciate that program, our program, the most, so they choose to go with us. And 2003 was actually the first year where we were the number one in the segment. BMW has been leading the segment for quite a few years, even prior to the year of 2000. But in 2003, we managed to close on top for the first time. And you see in this year, it's July year to date, we are continuing to grow our sales and continue the gap, grow the gap between us and BMW. So we are currently almost 400 cars ahead of BMW for 2005. So we also have, as we are in the travel business, we like to offer our customers some travel incentives as well, some added value to their overseas delivery experience. And about 64% of our customers stay between 7 and 20 days. So I think that's pretty remarkable, as Americans doesn't have that much vacation. But when they go pick up their Volvo in Europe, they decide to use that vacation and really get the most out of their experience. Excuse me. And we also have a winter offer, a low season offer, to attract customers to go in the traditional rainy season here. And for the past 2 years, we have offered London and Barcelona, trips to London and Barcelona, and 24% of our customers choose to go there. So that is, those trips were priced at $495. So it was a very attractive offer, I must say. And they spent 3 nights in either London and Barcelona, then they continued to Gothenburg, spent 2 nights here to pick up their new Volvo. We also offer drive tours in Scandinavia. The most popular one is the castle and manor houses, which you partially going to go through. It's a modified castle and manor houses tour we're going to do this week. You're going to do a more extended one. But that is by far the most popular trip. And I think that is because it isn't many castle and manor houses in the US. So my guess is that the Americans really enjoy this old style buildings. We also do some special trips and events where we do the yearly R event that has been very successful. We've done that for 3 years now, and it's been a remarkable success. It's a group event, and where the customers pay $3,495 extra to participate. So, but they get a lot for their money. They get, for example, business class tickets. But this is another way to really make the overseas delivery program unique and offer something that is not offered by any other manufacturer. So this year we went to the Formula One race at Nürburgring in Germany. And I think some of the comments we get during the trip is just amazing. And the first one is really encouraging. The trip exceeded my expectations. That is what we always try to do here, to meet and exceed our customers' expectations, to make sure that we continue our positive growth of the program. And the other one here that I'd like to point out is, this is my first Volvo, and after this trip, it is difficult to imagine buying another car with the quality of Volvo and the overseas delivery program. And I think this ties into that we really create customers for life through the overseas delivery program. Good. Now I'm gonna turn over to. We're gonna do the Q&A now, James.
We'll go through the 2006 wrap.
Okay. Sorry. So now James is gonna take over. Mr. Hope is gonna go through model year 2006 with you. Thank you, James.
With regards to the business presentation or housekeeping first.
The OD. I had the overseas delivery. I have two questions.
Okay.
How many of your customers, if you know, because you said customers for life, what percentage of them buy another Volvo? Obviously not most likely through the OD program, but...
That continue to buy Volvo.
Exactly.
I would have to get back to you on that one, actually, because I don't have a number on how many they actually come back and buy. But as you pointed out here, you had a friend that in the Volvo Club that bought 20 cars,
over the years.
And I have Mr. John Nielsen from Los Angeles. He has purchased 33 cars He's purchased a car every year since 1970-something, and every year he gives the car to one of his children.
Really good. Yeah. And is there a geographic demographic? A geographic demographic? Is there a particular people from this region tend to do it, or is it just spread all over the United States?
No, that's a good question, actually. Most of our customers come from the western part of the U.S. California, Oregon, and the state of Washington are huge markets, especially the state of Washington. Oregon and the state of Washington is the largest market.
Because the weather is the same.
Yeah, that's a good point.
And is that a big Birkenstock on the top of it? What is that?
Canoe?
That's a canoe. Yeah.
It's a canoe?
You'll be doing that tomorrow.
Just to clarify, the additional offers, London and Barcelona, that's a sort of stop off on the way here for a couple of nights, is it?
Or yeah, it's a stop off. On the way over
to pick up the car,
exactly. Yeah. So first you go to the Barcelona. This year it's going to be Barcelona and Stockholm, actually. So three nights in Barcelona or Stockholm first, and then you continue to Gothenburg and spend two nights here. And this year the trips are priced at $595
per person.
No, for two actually.
Wow.
So it's for two people. So it's a really good.
What star hotel? Five star hotel?
Five star. It's the Royal Viking Hotel in Stockholm, and it's the St. Moritz Hotel in Barcelona. The Barcelona, I think, is four star, and the Stockholm Hotel is five star. Yeah.
Well, at 03, you did Nice. I mean, I highly recommend the side trip. I mean, it's well worth it.
Oh, thank you. It's great you liked it.
Yeah, it was perfect.
What ports do you have for shipping the Cabify in Southern Europe?
In Southern Europe, we have Madrid. That is our most southern drop-off location. Madrid. And then you have the major capitals in Europe as drop-off points as well.
And how much extra do you take one of those?
Yeah, the drop-off points. The price there is from $300 up to $1,000. Because the further south in Europe drop the car off, the longer the inland transportation will be to the port. So that's what you actually pay for, to get the car from the drop-off location to the port in Seeburg in Germany.
So all the cars, no matter where you drop them off, go from the same location, go back to the U.S. from the same port.
Sorry?
All the cars, no matter where you drop them off, go back to the same port?
Yeah, pretty much. You have Bremerhaven in northern Germany as well, and Gothenburg.
So
about there. Sorry.
So you don't have an option, for instance, shipping from Southampton, or.
Sorry, you have.
You don't have the option of shipping from Southampton.
No, we don't. We don't have that. No.
The special trip, the R event. How does that work? Is that you drive your vehicle to?
So you drive your vehicle. You take the delivery here in Gothenburg. You take. We include a ferry ticket to Kiel in northern Germany. And then you drive on the Autobahn. This year we drove on the Autobahn down to Cologne, where we stayed. And then we had a bus going between Cologne and...
I missed it because I came late, but what is the average price saving for European delivery over U.S.?
It's about 8% on the MSRP.
And has that something to do with bringing the car back as a used car?
No, it doesn't. What we offer a upfront saving on the price instead of having incentives on financing and leasing. So we don't offer, like the manufacturers advertise, $299 a month, $399 a month on a lease. We don't have that kind of offer because 99% of our customers, they purchase the car. They are cash customers, if you want to call it that. So they are not that interesting in financing and leasing. Because if you look at leasing, for example, our car will, in most cases, the monthly payment will be, in most cases, higher than a if you buy a car from the dealer's inventory.
How is financing arranged?
The financing is arranged through Volvo Finance or through
any... The dealer
that's done at the retailer in the U.S., yeah. So that's Volvo Finance of North America that is arranged through. But many customers also also arrange finance through their local bank.
Is the price of the deal negotiable, or is it essentially a one price?
It is a set price for the overseas deal.
You know what we'll do for Jack and Herb? We'll take the two of you, because those questions are already run through, so we'll pull you guys off. No, that's okay. We'll just to kind of keep it moving along, but we'll give you all that. Additionally, on the CD, this presentation is in there, so that has all the numbers and things like that as well.
How many people did you have in the yard?
We had 13 cars, 26, two persons per car, so it's 26 people.
The cost of the event covers two people.
Yeah, the $3,495 is for two people.
As far as the insurance coverage is concerned, I understand that, that my information is correct, that in Germany they have had at least $1 billion worth of coverage.
Our insurance is, I don't know how it is in Germany, but it's a full coverage insurance with a deductible of about $500 deductible. Yeah. So, but it covers everything, so it's you don't need to worry about it. Yeah, everything. So it's all
getting back to your question, Jan, just high overview of the different programs. We've got the 8% savings, the two airline tickets, and the one-night hotel. Saab is about 11% savings, $2,000 towards airfare. That's it. Mercedes is 7% savings on select models. So, and this is information according to their website. And then BMW is up to 7% savings. That's it. So you can kind of see why we outsell.
Yeah.
The offer is pretty deep. Makes sense.